The Essential Guide to Furnishing Your First Home. Moving out is one of life's big milestones, but when you finally do it differs wildly. Many people leave home at 18, or even before then, but it's becoming more common to live with your parents for longer. A big reason for this is that it's becoming too expensive for a lot of young people to afford their own place. Even those who move out to go to college move right back home once they've graduated. You could be in your early 20s or older when you finally get your first real home. You might be renting, or you might be lucky enough to be buying, but either way you want to make your new house your own. If you're moving into an unfurnished house or apartment, it's both daunting and exciting. Faced with a blank canvas, you can do what you want. On the other hand, you're starting from the bottom with hardly any furniture or personal possessions. The essentials. Before you move in, check what your new home has in terms of major appliances. If you don't want to have to buy a washing machine, fridge, etc. when you move in, find an estate agent in Castle Lane, who will only show you homes that already have them. Your laundry facilities and kitchen are the main things to think about. You'll need a washing machine and possibly a dryer, although if you live in an apartment there may be a shared laundry room. Your kitchen needs an oven, fridge, freezer, and maybe a microwave. A dishwasher is an option too, but many people feel they're unnecessary if you don't have a family. Chances are your first home will have almost all of these already, but perhaps you'll want to replace them. How long are you staying? It's a good idea to have a rough idea of how long you'll be in the house before you decorate and furnish it. Do you want to settle down for several years or is it just somewhere to live until you move on to something better? If it's a temporary thing, don't go overboard with decorating. You might regret buying too much furniture when it's time to haul it across the country, or even across town. Save money. Furnishing a whole new home can be expensive. When you're starting off with nothing, even buying the essentials like a bed and mattress can cost a pretty penny. One way to save is buying secondhand. You spend less money, and it makes it easier to switch out your furniture for different pieces as your style evolves. Keeping costs down is also easier if you go for a minimal look. It's tempting when you have your own place to go crazy expressing your style, but if you're looking to save money, it's best to restrain yourself. Don't forget to take into account whether you're renting or you own your home when you decorate. Some things, such as painting the walls or changing carpets, will need your landlord's permission.